Now next question, question number 8. This is the solution which we are going to see now. You are given a spherical convex surface, convex towards this medium, air. The glass has a spherical convex surface towards air. Diagram is given. Glass refractive index 1.5, air refractive index of course 1. Radius of curvature of the surface is 20 given. An object is kept at a distance of 30 centimeter in front of the convex surface. Now you see, this is refraction at single refracting surface. This is not lens formula or lens maker's formula. Don't be using 1 by f is equal to 1 by v 1 minus 1 by u, or do not be using 1 by f is mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. This is a confusion which one will get. Don't use any lens maker's formula here. Simply use formula for refraction at single refracting surface. Very simple sum. It says refraction equation mu 2 by v minus mu 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. V image distance, u object distance, r radius of curvature, mu 2 refractive index of the second medium with respect to air. Object is kept here. So this is the second medium, this is the first medium. So mu 2 is the refractive index of the second medium with respect to air. Okay, mu 1 is the refractive index of the first medium with respect to air. But here the first medium itself is air, and instead of mu 2 he has given mu. Okay, this is a formula, but he has given mu as 1.5. So use this. You are supposed to find v. Therefore mu 2 by v is equal to, take this to the other side, mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. Minus is there, when it goes to the other side it becomes plus, plus mu 1 by u. Use sign convention. Of course mu 2 is 1.5. 1.5 you can write as 3 by 2 just for convenience sake. 3 by 2 v. Here don't give any sign convention because it's a quantity you are going to find out. For any quantity which you are going to find out, should not give sign convention. So leave it as it is. Mu 2 minus mu 1, 1.5 minus 1, 0.5 is half. So 1 by 2 r plus mu 1 is 1, 1 by u is 30. So minus 30 in centimeter. R is given 20 centimeter. But r is positive because this is the spherical surface, this is the direction of the incident ray. You are measuring all the distances from the pole or the center of the surface, refracting surface. So when you are measuring this distance, you will go like this. Therefore radius of curvature for this surface is positive, which is 20, 2r, so 40. Plus 1 by minus 30, because when you are measuring object distance, you will be going opposite to the direction of the incident ray. When you are measuring from here, you will go opposite to the direction of the incident ray. So minus 30. This is plus here, minus 30 is here. I change this to minus. So 1 by 40 minus 1 by 30 is equal to 3 by 2V. Now you can see, you can take LCM here. 120, 3 minus 4 minus 1 by 120, minus 1 by 120. So 3 by 2V is minus 1 by 120, therefore V is minus. Sorry, V is in the denominator. 3 by 2V, therefore V will be 3 by 2 into 120. Minus symbol is there. Okay, so simplify. 60, so minus 180 centimeter. Therefore, the image is formed at a distance of 180 centimeter here. This is 30, maybe image will be formed somewhere here. You will have to be very careful with the sign convention, otherwise you will get wrong answers. So how do you draw the diagram? See, this you take as a normal, because this is center for the surface, center of the curvature for this surface. Any line from the center of curvature for the spherical surface to the surface would be a normal. And so you can draw the diagram like this. This is where the image will be formed. This is broken line, dotted line. See, the ray goes from, this is actual ray, goes from rarer to denser. This is normal. It has to bend towards the normal. This ray is bending, instead of going straight, bends towards the normal. Though you extend it backward, it will meet the axis here. So I is the location. Pi will be equal to numerically 180 centimeter. This is a diagram for that. You'll have to draw the diagram properly. So the image will be formed right in front of the convex spherical surface. The image distance is 180 centimeter. Minus is coming, no, here. So let's just analyze this. More, suppose if this point is, why not it cuts this? You may get a doubt. Why not this refracted ray will cut this axis? But it may not cut, because this distance is like this. Distance is only 30 centimeter. If you want to find out for what distance of the object this refracted ray will go parallel to the axis, you can just do so. It's a little extra work. It's not at all asked in the question. It is some extra work we are doing here. Okay? Yeah. So how will you find out? Suppose the same thing. I just want to find out what is the distance of the object from the spherical surface such that the ray goes parallel with the axis. Now the ray is not going parallel, but if you want to find out, you see here, if the ray has to go parallel, you can take the image distance to be infinity, so this will go off. Therefore, mu 1 by u is equal to, this will be 0, mu 1 minus mu 2 by r. Because minus is there, I change into plus. Mu 1 is 1, 1 by u is equal to, again you don't give any sign convention here, because you want to find out for what distance to the object the refracted ray will go parallel. Mu 1 is 1, 1 here, minus 1.5, so minus half. R is 20. Therefore, u will be minus 40 centimeter. So if you keep the object at 40 centimeter, the ray will go parallel. Understand that? So instead of 30, if you keep the object at 40, so I'll just change this like this. If it is keeping at 40, the ray will go parallel. If it is at 30, it will not go parallel. The image distance will be here. You have to extend the ray backward. Suppose if it is more than 40, 30 is here. If you keep it more than 40, then the ray will bend further down. So more than 40, if you keep it at say something like 50, then the ray will bend, you will get the real image here. Understood that? Suppose If I take it as say 50 object distance, I want to find image distance, then the image will be formed this side. For 30 centimeter, image is formed on that side. Suppose I take it as 50 centimeter object distance, we will see where will the image be formed. So mu 2 by v, 3 by 2 v is equal to mu 1 will go to the other side, 1 by it will become plus mu plus u, but u I said you keep it as say 50, so minus 50. Sign convention, taken minus mu 1 by u to the other side becomes plus mu 1 by u, that u is minus 50. I am assuming if it is 50, what will happen? Let's say it is 50 centimeter. It will not go parallel, it will be meeting somewhere. It's okay, we just find out. Mu 1 is 1, u is 50. Take into the other side, that plus mu 2 minus mu 1 is half. R is plus 20. So 1 by 50 minus is there, plus 1 by 40. Can you take it as some 200 LCM? Minus 4 plus 5, 1 by 200, 3 by 2V is 1 by 200. So what will your V be then? V is equal to 3 by 2 into 200. So V is equal to 300 centimeter. So it will be formed at somewhat here, 300 centimeter. Understood that? So depending on the object distance, the image may be formed this side, or the image may be formed at infinity, or the image may be formed on the right side. So you can even show the variation graphically. Okay, variation. So I'll just show the variation now. This is the graph. Mu 2 by V minus we'll see, and now we'll explain how the image distance varies with the object distance. Now look at this. This gives you the variation of V with respect to u. The formula is mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by u, mu 2 minus mu 1 by r. This will be 40 centimeter. 40 centimeter we calculated, no? Previous sum. That is the sum we just now seen. 40 centimeter is the object distance, means image will be formed at infinity. So I just keep this. This is u and this is v. 40 centimeter, image will be formed at infinity. Anything say at 30, this is 40 centimeter, let's say 30 may be somewhere here, you can see it will intersect here. So image distance negative. Suppose if you go after this minus 40, say somewhat 50 here, you can see this is the object distance more than 40 numerical value, it will meet this at this point. So V will be positive, so image will be formed this side. See here, if the object is at 30 centimeter, this is 20 centimeter, object is here, image is formed here. Object is at 30, image will be formed on the left side. Suppose if the object is at 40 centimeter, refracted ray will go parallel, image will be formed at infinity. Object more than 40 centimeter distance, the rays will form the image on the principal axis to the right side of the convex surface. So if you take up this sum and analyze, you will get to know a lot of informations, and you will get to understand it better and better.